Hey guys, what we have here is a Panasonic Easa-Phone answering machine from 1989, dual cassette and voice time day stamp. I've seen a lot of these answering machines on YouTube, but surprisingly they don't have the time option on them, so I'm guessing this was just a higher model at the time, or maybe just it was like a rare thing to have back then. Nowadays it's pretty standard. But yeah, so it's dual cassette. Just show you the front here. There's the time, power in use, answer calls. There's your playback button. And you got your simple rewind, fast forward, and memo button. Memo button we're going to get into a little bit later. Little microphones right here. And then we have a look inside. Pretty simple. This is your outgoing message cassette. And your incoming message cassette, the incoming message goes to the left because, as you can see, it has to be mounted opposite of what the outgoing message cassette is. Now, I don't know if this was our very first answering machine that we ever had, but it was our very first for here. It was used all the time from 1990 until about, I'm going to say either 2000 or 2001, because at that time we got a new answering system and it had the whole, you know, digital thing without the cassette tapes now. The numbers you see on the cassette here are basically the number of minutes the tape can hold both sides combined. So, you know, this says C60, if it was the other way around. This says C60, so it means this side, side 1, holds 30 minutes, and side 2 also holds 30 minutes. And on the outgoing message cassette, this side holds 7.5, and the opposite side also holds 7.5. Let me just show you the back of it. Give you some of the info right here. Hopefully you can read that okay. It's direct current input, 12 volts. And there's the AC adapter that you want to use. And made in Japan. So there you go. Now, here's the serial number. Now, I'm going to guess that these last six numbers here are the date. And now, considering this was made in Japan, I'm going to go with 2nd of December, 1989. Okay, I don't know if that's true, but considering it's from there, that's my guess. And you can see it's held together by, looks like, four screws. I'm not going to open this machine, it works fine, but there's the stuff you need to know. And I'll show you what's on the inside once again. What I'll do is I'll take out the incoming message cassette. Pops out just like that. You can see you got your standard cassette tape set up. There's the, I think it's called a tape guide pin and the roller behind it. That's your record playback head, and that's your erase head, I believe. And just your standard tape reels, and these are just the guides to help the tape in, these two things right here. And here's the cassette tape from this angle. You see the little window, shows you how much tape is on each reel. And same thing on the other side, just side two. And yeah, pretty much the same thing. So we'll side one, put that back in. There you go, fits right in, perfect. So now, I can also show you the buttons here. You have a time day check. If it focuses, there you go. You got your time adjust, outgoing message record, outgoing message play, and incoming message erase. And we'll get to that a little bit later. And there's a few things I can show you along the side of it. On this side, there's this remote code, I believe it's called. Will it focus? There it goes. There was a whole setup for that. Jay told me how to do it a couple weeks ago, but I forget the whole thing, but I don't want to go into too much detail. So there's a remote code, there's the volume slider, and on the other side, there's your power button. It's electronic control, power button, and over here you have the recording time. That means it'll record for 1 minute, or depending on the volume. I believe that's what VOX stands for. So when it stops hearing audio, it stops. And number of rings, you can have 2, 4, or auto. And I forget what auto does, but there you go. 2 rings could be for, like, you know, let's say you're on vacation. Obviously, no one's going to be answering the phone. Put it to 2, and then the answering machine answers the call for you. Now, this is not going to be the first time it's been plugged in since 2000 or 2001. I actually did that middle of last month, because I finally found the power adapter for it. Yeah, I couldn't find that for the longest time. And my initial concern was, Spatz Bear had actually made a video in 2010 of his, I believe, 1970s Ampex tape recorder. It was mint in the box. In fact, it was never opened. But because it sat unused all those years, the belt inside that actually moved the reels, I think, had weakened, because even though they weren't being used, they were stretched and under tension for so long. And I think the sound capacitors were bad or something, too. He'd be able to answer that more correctly if he decides to. But in my case, upon plugging it in and, you know, testing it, running some things, it ran perfectly. For cassette tape quality, the sound still sounds very good after all those years. Because, you know, it was in a dry room and it was covered with this all those years it wasn't used, so it protected the cassette tapes very well. And it worked great. So, all right, so let's go ahead and we're going to plug it in, and I'll show you some of the operation of it. Actually, before I do that, I want to show you the power adapter information. You can see the input is 120 volts, 60 hertz, 12 watts and 0.1 amps, and the output, as you saw before, 12 volts and approximately 500 milliamps. So really not all that much that it uses. Now look at this though, the power adapter is made in China. That's very interesting. Not sure how that works, but hey, it works, so that's all that matters. Alright, let's plug it in now. Okay, it's plugged in, and the first thing you may notice is that the time light is blinking. And that's just because, kind of like when you set up, when you plug in a digital clock, it blinks 12 a.m. until you manually reset the time. So the way you set it is, if you open up the cover, on here it tells you how to adjust the time. You just hit time adjust, then use the rewind and fast forward buttons to set the date, to set the day or the minute or the hour, and then you use memo to go to the next thing. One of the kind of annoying things is that since the incoming message tape goes in this direction, rewind does go back and fast forward does go forward, but as you can see, the arrows face opposite directions because of the way the tape is set up. So when you're trying to set the time, you may get confused at first, but it's usually very quick to fix. And so let's see, it is currently, my phone says 9:21, so let's set it to that as close as we can. So we're going to hit time adjust.
Sunday.
And you can hear it said Sunday, and I just put the volume all the way up. So now you want to set it to today's Monday, so hit fast forward.
Monday.
Okay. Now we want to go to the next thing, so hit memo.
12 a.m.
Okay, and now it's the hour is currently 9, so we want to go backwards.
11 p.m., 10 p.m., 9 p.m.
Okay, now we want to set the minute.
Oh.
And one of the hard things about this is that it's best if you do it at the top, towards the top of the hour, because I can't go through the minutes fast. I have to wait until he stops talking. So if I go this way.
01, 02, 03, 04.
And you get the bit. You get the idea. Let me just do this, and I'm not going to make you sit through him saying every single number. Actually, what you can do is if you hold it down.
17, 18, 19, 20, 21. 22.
There you go. It goes a little bit faster. Then just hit the time adjust button again.
Monday, 9:22 p.m.
And as you notice, all it does is it just gives you the day and the hour. And without the date, it could basically go for as long as it wants, because it doesn't have to give you a year. And as Jay said, it's Y2K compatible, which is kind of cool. So, and if you want to check the time again, just hit this button.
Monday. 9:22 p.m.
And there you go. Okay, let's go ahead and hit the power button on the right side and see what happens. Okay, it just rewound the outgoing message cassette. Now it's going to wind it up to where the magnetic portion of the tape begins. And now it's going to announce the time. And that's one of the cool things about this machine is that, you know, all tapes have a very beginning section of tape where it's totally blank and nothing magnetic on it, and obviously you can't record on that portion of the tape. So for both tapes, the machine will actually play the tape until it reaches that magnetic portion and then stops it. So that way when it records every single portion of audio, which is really good. Okay, now I don't currently have the machine connected to the phone line, but it shows here that it's on and it can answer calls if it gets any. So to start, what I'm going to do is I'm going to play back the outgoing message on here, And this outgoing message is going to be my mom's voice. And again, this outgoing message is from like I said, we're talking 15, 16 years ago. So it'll be very interesting for you guys to hear. You'll hear most of it, not all of it. I'm just going to mute out where she says the phone number. But you can get the basic idea of how it all works. And then again, once it's over, it's going to rewind the tape back and then play it just to the magnetic portion to begin. All right, here we go.
You have reached. Please leave a message. Thank you.
As you can see, you know, it announces the time during lots of times, so it really isn't all that bad. Like, it's not that loud of a voice and everything. So there was the outgoing message portion, and let me show you how we can make the incoming message portion work. Alright, so even though I don't have this connected to a phone line, the way I can make it record an incoming message is with the memo option. Now, what the memo option does is, you know, let's say, for example, someone at your house, you know, we'll use your spouse in this for this example, they want to leave you a message of some kind of like a note. They can hit memo, it'll record, and then when it stops recording their message, it'll let you know that it has new messages. I'll show you the details of that in a little bit, but that's how the memo option works, and this is what we're going to use to test out the incoming message portion. Okay, and since I don't want to mess up the audio with the recording, I'll explain to you how the memo function works right now. So, when you hold down memo, it's going to start recording, then you record your message, and then when you're done, you hit memo again, it'll beep, then it'll announce the time, which it'll record onto the tape, so it knows when the memo was recorded, then it'll finish recording, and then that's it. So, let's get to it. Now, I just want to tell you guys in advance that I'm going to be having a little bit of fun with this, okay? So, let's be silly. And with the first recording, here we go. Hey, Jay, I called your house before and you didn't answer. Oh, then I drove past your house. I saw your car was in the driveway. So, you're not answering your phone now. Oh, well, what's going on? Why don't you want to talk? I hear you going over to Sharky's now. Oh. Place with 150 PSI water pressure. Oh, well, I'm sitting here in the kitchen now. Casson made me a sandwich. In fact, I knew the sandwich was ready when I heard this. Stop that. Stop that.
Monday, 9:34 p.m.
So there's one example of how you can record a message. And as you notice, the red light that says answer calls is now blinking. And it's blinking like that because it's letting you know that you have a new message to listen to. Now, I'll record two messages. I won't go past two because now by that point it's just kind of dragging on. And you probably already got an idea, but I'll show you exactly how it lets you know that you now have two messages recorded, okay? So let's go ahead and do the second one and have fun with this too. Here we go. Bam! Yo, this is a record store. I wanted to sell you my record. I'll make you my biggest fan.
Monday, 9:35 p.m.
Guys, I'm sorry. Hold on. Okay, sorry about that. I just had to get some laughter out after that. Now, as you can see here, the red light is still blinking, but you notice it has a blink of two for a pattern now. And that simply means that you have two new messages. And the way you listen to them is you simply hit the playback button. Now, let's see how these sound in the audio of a 80s cassette tape, huh? And it still sounds pretty good. So, let's hit playback and let's listen to them.
Why don't you want to talk? I hear you going over to Sharky's now. Oh, place with 150 PSI water pressure. Oh, well, I'm sitting here in the kitchen now. Casson made me a sandwich. In fact, I knew the sandwich was ready when I heard this. Stop that. Stop that.
Monday, 9:34 p.m.
Bam! Yo, this is a record store. I wanted to sell you my record. I'll make you my biggest fan.
Monday, 9:35 p.m.
And those three beeps just mean it's the end of the messages, and I'll announce the current time.
Monday, 9:39 p.m.
And as you notice, the answer calls light went back to being solid. So basically, it only blinks when you get new messages since the last playback. Now you can see that there is some tape on the incoming reel, but the light is solid. So if you were to record two more messages right now, it would just blink two times again and not four. So that's basically how it works. Now there's actually two ways you can bring about the tape back to the beginning. You can simply hit rewind and it'll bring the tape back to the beginning, and then whatever messages you get will just record over the existing ones. But if you hit incoming message erase, it'll actually rewind the tape, erasing the messages that are on it and starting from the beginning. Now they're really smart in the design, because if I hit it like normal, nothing happens. So like, you know, if you hit it by accident, no problem, you know, just make sure you take your finger off fast enough. So what you want to do is you want to hold it down and it'll erase the messages. And it just brought it back to the magnetic portion again. And it'll bring the time once more.
Monday, 9:41 p.m.
And just to show you that the messages are indeed erased, I'll fast forward the tape just a little bit, then I'll hit playback. And as you can see, nothing. Nothing's coming out of the speaker whatsoever. So that just tells you that the messages are indeed erased. So let's pause it. And if you notice, when you pause it, the light blinks to let you know that it's paused, so that you know to stop it again, because if it's paused, it can't answer calls, as you can see. So we'll just hit rewind to bring it back to the beginning. Interestingly enough, it fast forwards the incoming message tape to the magnetic portion. The outgoing message cassette doesn't do that.
Monday, 9:42 p.m.
And at the same time, the grandfather clock's chiming. It's a little bit ahead, I gotta fix that. But basically, guys, there you go. That's the 1989 Panasonic Easa-Phone answering machine for you. Figured I'd have a little bit of fun with that for you. And, you know, maybe someday this will go back into service. Who knows? Even with, you know, the way the phone lines are, as long as you have a working phone line, this will still work. So it's good to use even for today. And the wear on the cassettes doesn't even sound that bad for, because like I said, it got a good 10, 11 years of service before we use something else. So really is made well, and I like how it works. So guys, there's my more like silly demonstration of it. And I hope you enjoyed this answering machine. I sure did. And hope you guys enjoy listening to my being silly, like I like to do a lot of times. So, as usual, guys, thanks a lot for watching, and take care.